الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek help from Him, we ask forgiveness from Him, we seek refuge in Him from our own evils and from our own sins. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can misguide. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides, no one can guide them to the straight path. And I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alone without any partners. And I bear witness that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is his final prophet and messenger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's peace and blessings be upon him, his family, his companions, and those who followed him until the day of judgment. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, we lived the blessed month of Ramadan, its beautiful days and its fragrant nights. We lived the month of Quran. We lived the month of taqwa. We lived the month of patience. We lived the month of mercy. We lived the month of forgiveness and freedom from the hellfire. Have we fulfilled the requirements of taqwa and graduated from the Ramadan school with the diploma of the good God forgiving? Have we fought our souls and desires and defeated them? Or have we been overtaken by our customs and blind imitations? Have we performed our actions in a way that fulfills the conditions for receiving mercy, receiving forgiveness, and realizing and release from the hellfire? Many questions and numerous thoughts come to our heart of the sincere believer who asks and answers with truthfulness. Ramadan was the school of Iman and a stuff to recharge one's spiritual batteries, to acquire one's provision from the rest of the year. For when will one take a lesson and change for better if not the month of Ramadan? The noble month is the true school of transformation in which we change our actions. We change our habits and manners that are at variance with the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ra'd, verse number 11, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُوا مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change the condition of a person until they change what is in themselves. If you are from those who benefited from the month of Ramadan, fulfilled the requirements of taqwa, truly fasted the month and prayed in it with truthfulness, and strove against your soul, then praise and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask Him for steadfastness upon it until we meet our death. Be not like one who has so assured and then destroyed it. Have you seen one who threw this shirt or thobe, and when he looked at it, he liked it? Then he destroyed it, pulling the thread by thread for no reason. What would people say about such a person? And there are many examples. This is the condition of one who returns in sinning and evil doing after the month of Ramadan and leaves obedience and righteous actions. So after he was favored with the blessings of obedience and enjoyment of communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he returned to the blaze of sins and evil actions. How evil are the people who know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only in the month of Ramadan, respected brothers and sisters in Islam. Falling short in one's commitment to Islam after the month of Ramadan is manifested in many ways. A person leaving the 5 daily prayer in congregation after they filled mosque for Taraweeh prayer, those giving the masjid for recommended prayers and leaving the obligatory prayers. And there are many other examples we can give. This is not thankfulness for blessings and favors, nor it is a sign of acceptance of one's actions. Rather, this is opposition to favors and absence of thankfulness. These are from the signs of one's deeds not being accepted. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refused his sword for one who is truly fast, rejoice on the occasion of Eid prayers, and praising his Lord for helping him complete the fast, and remains fearful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may not accept his fasting, just as Salaf would continue asking for the acceptance of their actions in the month of Ramadan for 6 months after it. From the signs that one's deeds are accepted is that he or she has improved in his or in her obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Ibrahim, verse number 7, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. And remember, when your Lord proclaimed, if you are grateful, I will surely increase you in favor, increase you in good, increase you in faith and righteous actions. So if the servant is truly thankful to his Lord, you will see him guided to more obedience and distance from sinfulness. Thankfulness is leaving sins. As the early Muslims said, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Hijr, verse number 99, وَعَبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. And worship your Lord until there comes to you the certainty, the death. The Muslim must continuously be in the state of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, firm upon his sharia, steadfast upon his deen, so that he or she is not of those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only during 1 month or only in one place. Rather, the believer knows that the Lord of Ramadan is also the Lord of other months, and that he is the Lord of all times and places. So he is steadfast upon the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until he meets him while he is pleased with him. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Hud, verse number 112. So remain on the right course as you have been commanded, and those who have turned back with you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Fussilat, verse number 6, so take a straight course to Him and seek His forgiveness. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, say, I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then be steadfast. Narrated by Muslim. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Amma ba'd, respected brothers and sisters in Islam, if the fasting in the month of Ramadan has ended, there are remains voluntary fasting, such as the fasting of the 6 days of Shawwal, and on the Mondays and Thursdays of every week, and 3 days in the middle of the month of Islamic calendar, the days of Ashura and the day of Arafah, and so many other. If standing in prayer at night during the month of Ramadan has ended, but then there remains voluntary night prayer throughout the year. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Az-Zariyat, verse number 17, كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون. They used to sleep, but little on the night. If the charity in the month of Ramadan and Zakatul Fitr has ended, then there is an obligatory Zakat. And also there are many other open doors to charity and donation, voluntary actions. Reading of the Holy Quran and the recitation of the Holy Quran and contemplating, it is not only for the month of Ramadan, rather, it is for all times. Righteous actions are for all times and all places. So strive, respected brothers and sisters in Islam, and be aware of laziness, and remember that it is not allowed for us to leave the obligatory actions or delay them, such as the daily 5 daily prayers, obligatory prayers on its timing in congregation, and do not fall into forbidding actions, such as forbidden saying, food, drinks, or by looking at things that are forbidden by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be steadfast and upright upon the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times, for you do not know when we will meet the angels of death. Be aware of him taking us while we are in a state of sin. O Allah, who turns the hearts, keep our hearts steadfast upon your deen. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us and from you all our fasting, our prayers, and other righteous actions, that our conditions after Ramadan be a better one, that the state of our ummah improves, that we are granted honor, and that we are truly turned to our Lord. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us more ability and strength so that we can practice His deen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us understand according to the Quran and the Sunnah of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And those who are sick, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cure them and give them complete shifa. And those who have passed away, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive their sins and grant them highest place in Jannatul Firdaus. Inna Allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli 'ala Muhammad wa 'ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita 'ala Ibrahim wa 'ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الكفرة والملحدين ودمر أعداء الدين وانصر عبادك الموحدين وانصر عبادك المخلصين وانصر عبادك المؤمنين ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين أقم الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله استو استقيموا واعتدلوا تراصوا وسدوا الخلل please straighten your lines and don't leave any gaps الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر.